Welcome to Mysteries and Crime. I'm your host, Melissa Thompson. On March 12, 2021, 6-year-old Grace Ross was reported missing by her family in New Carlisle, Indiana. 2 hours later, at 8:25 p.m., she would be found deceased on Chapman Drive in a wooded area, which is located about half a mile from her Olive Elementary School. She was in kindergarten there. Court documents say the St. Joseph County Metro Homicide Unit was alerted to the discovery of a 6-year-old girl's body today in New Carlisle around 8 p.m. on March 12, 2021. After little Grace's body was found, a woman took her 14-year-old son into the police station because apparently he had seen the little girl in the woods. The teen was quickly interviewed by investigators. He said Grace followed him into the woods, and he wandered around and lost track of her. Both the teen and Ross lived in the same apartment complex. It is not known, however, whether the two knew each other prior to March 12th of 2021. The suspect said that, quote, a shadowy man took control of his hands and made him strangle little Grace. End quote. The teen said he felt her soul/spirit leave her body. He then checked for a pulse to make sure she was really dead. He then ran back home to his apartment, washed blood off of his hands, took a shower, and hid his dirty clothes. The suspect did not explain to authorities why Grace Ross was naked when they found her. Police took him into custody, and the boy faces 2 counts of murder and 1 count of child molestation. His attorney, Heidi Cintron, requested that details of the case remain sealed, but the judge ruled that some of the court proceedings and details would become public. The teen suspect is under psychological evaluation. It will be determined at a later time whether he will be charged as an adult or a juvenile. At a court hearing, the defendant voiced confusion at his hearing, telling the judge he did not, quote, really understand much of what is going on, end quote, according to WNDU. The judge asked what he did not understand. The defendant said he did not understand the, quote, child molestation part of the charges, end quote. Grace's grandfather, Timothy Howard, voiced sympathy for the defendant's mother amid the hearing. He said, quote, well, as I sat there, I looked at the mom. I couldn't make eye contact with her, he said. I could look at someone that's a working day mom, just like everyone else, probably doing the best that she could. I can't see holding her responsible. Howard demanded justice, though, saying, quote, he committed a crime that he has to pay for, and that's what we want, end quote, he said, according to WSBT. Quote, we want him to get justice, end quote. Her grandmother, Kelly Howard, told WNDU-TV about how Grace loved to sit in her lap, cuddle, and admire her grandmother's jewelry. Quote, I always told her that when her fingers get big enough to fit these rings, that she could have them, and her hands never got to be past a baby's hands. She told ABC 57, quote, I love her, and I hope that she's with family in heaven. Grace Ross's, end quote, Grace Ross's cause of death was asphyxiation, ruled as a homicide. She was found dead at 8:25 p.m. on March 12, 2021, police reports have said. A candlelight vigil was held on March 14, 2021, at Memorial Park in New Carlisle, Indiana, where friends, family, and neighbors gathered in Grace's memory. ABC 57 reported, more than 200 people came along, placing candles, flowers, and stuffed animals in a gazebo and on a park bench. Michelle Ross, Grace's mother, said at the vigil, quote, Grace was loved by everybody, and she was friends with everybody. She would go up to a stranger on the street and be like, hi, I'm Grace, and I'm 6, end quote. Tara Bush, the principal of the elementary school Grace attended, said at the vigil, quote, you could tell she was smiling all the time, end quote. The superintendent of the school system said in a statement, quote, "Our school district and school family has suffered a tremendous loss. This past Friday evening, one of our fellow students in kindergarten at Olive Elementary died." Quote, "The circumstances of the student's death are under investigation. Local police have arrested a suspect and have them in custody," end quote. Funeral services took place on the morning of March 20th of 2021. Burial services are planned at a later date. An obituary by the Palmer Funeral Homes in South Bend, Indiana, paid tribute to the young girl. And these are the words I'll leave you with. A student at Olive Elementary School in New Carlisle, Indiana, and remembered her as, quote, "the light in the room." It continued, quote, "the brightest flower in the vase. She could change your mood from bad to good and from good to great. She was friendly, outgoing, kind, cheerful, and one of a kind. In short, amazing. She was loved by all and will be missed by many." According to the obituary, the six-year-old is survived by many, including her mother, stepfather, father, paternal grandmother, maternal grandparents, and her great-grandparents. Fly high, sweet angel, look over your family. God gained a beautiful flower when he got you for his garden. Thank you, everybody, for watching. Take care.
If I could turn the hourglass over, if I could set the clock back, you wouldn't change a thing, I know that, I know that. And when I look at the world around me, I see what might have been, but every deed has got a price tag. Now I know. You call me by name, you cut me wide open, you play me like a game, and this is what it's like living your life in regret. I wish I never met.